Hey guys, welcome back to the world of aquariums. Today we'll be talking about water hardness and how to soften your water in your aquarium. This process is actually very easy to do, and I'll first give you a general run through of what water hardness is, why you might want to soften your water, and the different ways of doing so. For starters, your water hardness is how hard or how soft your water is, and this is measured as GH, which stands for general hardness. Your general hardness will be purely made of the two mineral salts, which are calcium and magnesium. Unless you're using pure water, all water will have some amount of hardness which can be measured using a GH test kit. For example, water with a GH of 3 degrees will be considered as soft water, while water with a GH of 10 degrees will be considered as hard water. Although it is true that most fish can adapt to a wide range of water hardness, there are still some benefits and reasons why you would want to soften your water. The main reason is that the hardness of your water used to fill up your fish tank or perform water changes with might not be suitable or in the correct range for the fish you want to keep. Most people will use tap water to fill up their tanks, and both general hardness and other parameters can vary quite a lot depending on their location. So while someone else's water hardness from the tap are perfectly fine for the type of fish, your own tap water might not be suitable for the same type of fish. Even if you live in the same city as someone else, your own water parameters might be different. So basically, if your tap water is too hard, you will need to find ways to soften your water. Secondly, some fish and aquatic animals are naturally found in very soft water environments or have less tolerance to hardness levels outside the suited range, such as crystal shrimps and rams. By having soft water, this will replicate the natural environment and allow these animals to thrive, ultimately improving their health and coloration. The same thing goes with breeding, where having soft water will better induce breeding behavior for aquatic organisms that are naturally found in these soft water environments. So now that we have gone through different reasons you might want to soften your water, I'll go through the different ways to do this, and also how strong or weak of an effect each of these would have in softening your water. Your substrate and your hardscape are things you add during your initial setup of your fish tank, which can help bring down the hardness. Both of these I have put as having a weak effect in softening your water, and their effects will eventually get exhausted over time. Your substrate, such as aquarium soil, are used to create soft acidic environments by retaining the mineral ions into the soil particles. As such, these substrates are commonly used for planted tanks. Most of the fish types that are found in these planted tanks are also naturally found in soft water environments. On the other hand, most types of gravel are inert and will not affect the hardness of your water. However, other substrates such as coral sand will, and this will increase the hardness of your water, and you definitely do not want to add this if you want soft water. For the hardscape, large pieces of driftwood slightly decreases the hardness of your water, but will have a more significant effect in decreasing the pH of your water. These driftwoods will produce tannins, and whilst it does make your water appear brown, it is completely safe for your fish. Some people will purposely sort out this look, and these aquariums are called black water aquariums. Now that we have covered ways to soften your water through your initial tank setup, we will move on to ways to soften your water after the initial tank setup. This includes the best method with the strongest effect, and that is to change the type of water you are using to fill up the aquarium itself. This can be switching from tap water into rainwater, distilled water, or RODI water, which stands for reverse osmosis deionized water. Rainwater will always be naturally soft, so definitely use this if you have a rainwater tank on hand. For RODI water, most aquarium stores will sell RODI water or the RODI unit itself, which will allow you to make it at home. Distilled water is also quite similar, and you can buy from most supermarkets. If you have a large tank or multiple tanks, I would probably recommend investing in an RODI unit as they are quite cheap in the long run. The reason this is the most effective method is because it allows you to freely control what hardness you want your water to be at from the start. Also, if you are using very hard water for water changes, eventually it will exhaust up the other methods you have added. So for example, adding tap water with high GH will eventually exhaust the buffering capacity of soil. Please note, if you are using RODI water or distilled water, you will need to remineralize the water back or mix in some tap water, as both will be completely free of general hardness. and even saltwater fish will require some amounts. The next thing you can add is to use products such as water softening pillows, which will have a strong effect in softening water and decreasing your GH. These can be bought at your local aquarium store and can be either placed directly into your fish tank or filter. Essentially, these are just small pouches of deionized resin, which is one of the main components of RADI filter units. These pouches work as the resin will absorb the calcium and magnesium ions from the water that passes through it and therefore soften it. Finally, you can add Indian almond leaves or similar botanicals and black water extracts, which will slightly decrease the hardness of your water. However, these will have a stronger impact in creating acidic environments, so I would not recommend adding these if you are after soft but alkaline water. Anyway, this concludes our video on how to decrease your water hardness or soften your water. If you're also from Sydney in Australia, please check out Hurstville Aquarium and I have linked the website down below. For any inquiries or questions, just leave a comment and I'll answer them. I hope you have enjoyed this video and found it very helpful. Thanks for watching.